السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This lecture is a continuation of the previous lecture of the scrotum. The last lecture talk about the anatomy of the scrotum, embryology, and understand the testis and testicular torsion. We said in the last lecture we have main five topics in the scrotum. Two were clinical cases in the last year exam, and three topics were important topics for you as a clinician or as a doctor, must diagnose them early and treat them as early as possible. We will take today the first two clinical cases in the last year exam, varicocele and the first is a varicocele, which is a common clinical case in the last year exam. What's the meaning of the varicocele? From the anatomy, we know that the drainage of the venous drainage of the testis is the bambiniform plexus, which is 4 to 6 veins, which drain into the IVC on the right side and drain into the left renal vein on the left side. What's the meaning of the varicocele? Varicocele meaning the dilatation and the elongation and tortuosity of the bambiniform plexus. The dilatation and elongation and tortuosity of the bambiniform plexus is the varicocele. Varicocele has many etiologies, but we have a primary varicocele and the secondary varicocele. Primary varicocele, which have no obvious cause, we don't know the exact cause of the varicocele in this case, which is called the primary varicocele, but we have some predisposing factors, like the congenital weakness of the veins. The patient of the varicocele, primary varicocele, may have varicose veins. Varicose veins due to venous weakness all over the body, congenital weakness of the veins, or congenital absence of the valves, normally present at the termination of this testicular vein. The added factors like prolonged standing or sitting, chronic constipation, or congestion due to unrelieved sexual excitement are the predisposing factors of the varicocele. Secondary varicocele, we have a cause for obstruction of the veins, like obstruction of the testicular veins, mainly on the left side, due to hypernephroma. Hypernephroma, which is the malignancy of the kidney, renal malignancy, renal cell carcinoma, leads to permeation of the veins, tumor embolism, which block the left renal vein, leading to obstruction of the bambiniform plexus, which drain into the left renal vein on the left side. Closure of the vein by permeation of the malignant cells, tumor emboli, which is the secondary varicocele. The other cause of the secondary varicocele is the retroperitoneal fibrosis. We know that the bambiniform plexus of veins drain into the left renal and the IVC, which is a retroperitoneal structures. Idiopathic retroperitoneal fibrosis leading to fibrosis around the bambiniform plexus and their obstruction leading to secondary varicocele. We have two etiologies for the varicocele. Primary, no obvious cause, but there is a predisposing factors like the congenital weakness of the veins and prolonged standing. This is the main two predisposing factors of the primary varicocele. Secondary varicocele, mainly due to hypernephroma. What's the pathology of the hydrocele? Usually, the primary varicocele occur in young population, 15 to 30 years old. The veins are patent but incompetent, leading to regurgitation of the blood in the vein. While the secondary varicocele, the vein is blocked, occluded by the malignant cells. Also, hypernephroma occurs in old population, so secondary varicocele occur in old age population. What's the problem of the varicocele? We have a problem here. The problem of the varicocele is increasing the temperature of the testis, leading to hypofertility or infertility, especially in bilateral cases, due to increased temperature. We know that the testis descend to the scrotum in the intrauterine life due to increasing temperature or intra-abdominal temperature. The temperature inside the scrotum is less than the intra-abdominal temperature. But in the varicocele, due to stasis of the blood inside the scrotum, leading to increasing the temperature. We know from the previous lecture, the undescended testis, there is infertility and atrophy of the testis due to increasing temperature. So also varicocele leading to increasing temperature inside the scrotum lead to defect in the spermatogenesis, hypofertility and infertility. The other cause of the hypofertility or infertility is the reflux of the steroids and catecholamines, which leads to inhibition of the spermatogenesis. We know that the left bambini foramoplexus drain into the left renal vein. Also, the left adrenal gland, which secretes the catecholamines, drain into the left renal vein. Incompetent valves of the bambini foramoplexus leading to regurgitation of the blood, which contain the catecholamines and steroids in the bambini foramoplexus. The steroids and catecholamines leading to inhibition of the spermatogenesis. But why this occurs in bilaterally, leading to infertility? Because but we have connections between the two testes, so the steroids and the catecholamines is derived from the left side of the scrotum to the right side, leading to destruction also of the left testis and inhibition of the spermatogenesis. Long-standing cases, this leads to testicular atrophy, not only inhibition of the spermatogenesis. In very rare cases, secondary hydrocele occur due to varicocele and thrombophlebitis. Thrombophlebitis, which leads to pain. Thrombophlebitis of the veins, and inflammation inside the bambini foramoplexus veins, leading to pain. Maybe severe pain, which is an indication for surgery. What are the complications of the varicocele? Infertility and hyperfertility due to increasing temperature and the reflux of the catecholamines and steroids. Testicular atrophy, secondary hydrocele, and thrombophlebitis. What are the incidence of the varicocele? Varicocele is common in young adult males from 15 to 30 years old, and secondary varicocele is common in old age and middle age males more than 40 years old. The varicocele is common on the left side. Why it's common on the left side? Because the left testis hangs lower than the right one. Normally, the left testis descends to the scrotum before the right testis. So the left testis lay down more than the right one. This leads to elongation of the left testicular veins. Left testicular vein drain into the left renal vein directly by a right angle. This right angle opens obliquely, but the right opens obliquely on the IVC. Right angle leads to reflux of the blood more than on the right side. On the left side, we have the sigmoid colon, which may be loaded with feces, leads to compression of the bambini foramoplexus of veins or testicular veins in the retroperitoneum. Left colon, sigmoid colon, may be loaded with feces, compress the left testicular vein. Lastly, the nutcrack effect. Nutcrack effect, what's the meaning of nutcrack? Nutcrack, the nutcrack is a machine which procs the nuts. The nutcrack effect of the superior mesenteric artery and the aorta on the left renal vein. Superior mesenteric artery raises by an angle from the aorta. If this angle becomes more acute, it's compressed the left renal vein. More compression of the left renal vein leading to reflux of the blood into the left testicular veins. We have four causes leading to increased instance of the left varicocele more than the right varicocele. At first, the left testis lays down more than the right testis because it descends at first. The second cause is the right angle of drainage of the left testicular vein into the left testicular vein into the left renal vein. The third is the sigmoid colon on the left side, which may be loaded with feces, compress the left testicular vein. Lastly, the nutcrack effect of the superior mesenteric artery. Nutcrack effect, compression of the left renal vein between the aorta and the superior mesenteric artery. What are the symptoms and signs of the varicocele? Usually, the varicocele is asymptomatic in most of cases. Undiscovered accidentally during routine examination. But the symptoms range from pain, which may be dull aching pain due to congestion, or dragging pain in the cord in the late cases due to prolonged standing and hot weather. Swelling, which may be moderate or severe, and patients feel the scrotum as a bag of form. May be complicated with thrombophlebitis leading to severe pain. And the patient may complain from the infertility, you know, which is the most common presentation of the varicocele actually is the infertility. What are the signs? Generally, we must examine the abdomen in the case of the varicocele. Why? To exclude the renal mass. We must examine the abdomen to exclude the renal mass. We must examine the body as a whole to exclude the general weakness of the veins like the varicose vein, bile's hernia, general weakness in the connective tissue. Locally, by inspection, the testis, which affected by the varicocele, hangs lower than the normal one. Scrotum is redundant with visible veins, like in this picture, with visible veins on the skin of the scrotum. This veins is dilated and tortuous. By palpation on the standing position, the swelling is at the level of the neck of the scrotum, which is soft compressible swelling, goinoscrotal swelling, have impulse and cough, or even thrill in many cases. The swelling disappears when laying down in the primary varicocele, but in the secondary varicocele, when laying down and elevation of the testis, the swelling doesn't disappear because there is a higher obstruction due to permeation emboli of the malignant cells. So, how to diagnose a case of varicocele? Usually, the patient came to your clinic by complaining from infertility or complaining of a pain in the testis, chronic pain, not acute pain. Remember that the acute scrotal pain is due to two causes, testicular torsion and acute epididymorchitis. This was in the last lecture. But chronic dull aching pain in the scrotum, usually varicocele. So, we will examine the scrotum. By inspection, we see dilated veins, redundant skin, tortuous veins on the skin of the scrotum. When we palpate this swelling, the swelling is inguinoscrotal swelling. What's the meaning of inguinoscrotal swelling? When I put my index finger and my thumb at the level of the root of the penis, the swelling is between my thumb and my index finger. This is called inguinoscrotal swelling. With impulse and cough, or even thrill in severe cases. When the patient laying down and we elevate the testis, elevate the scrotum, the swelling disappears in the primary varicocele. While in the secondary varicocele, it doesn't disappear because there is a higher obstruction. Yeah, so varicocele is inguinoscrotal swelling with impulse or thrill and cough with sensation of bag of worms. This is varicocele. What's the investigation of choice? We will ask for duplex ultrasound. Duplex ultrasound, which sees the vessels. We know the duplex ultrasound is the ultrasound which sees the flow of the blood inside the vessels. Duplex ultrasound to confirm the diagnosis. If we suspect secondary varicocele, we must ask for abdominal ultrasound to exclude a renal mass. Actually, we do semen analysis not for diagnosing of the varicocele, but for medico-legal importance, because if we do the operation and patient become oligospermic after the operation, it will ask you that the operation leads to oligospermia. So we do semen analysis before the operation to detect the complications. What's the differential diagnosis of the varicocele? Inguinal scrotal swellings in general, like inguinal hernia. But the inguinal hernia has embarrassing cough and reducibility. It's reduced, not thrill, and no sensation of bag of worms. How to differentiate between the primary varicocele and secondary varicocele? Primary varicocele occurs in young populations, 15 to 30 years old, with gradual onset and long duration, usually occur in the left side, and disappear on laying down. The abdominal examination is free. While the secondary varicocele occurs in older population, with sudden acute onset and short duration, occurs in both sides equally. No changes with position, laying down and derivation of the scrotum doesn't disappear. Delphi abdominal mass may be present. What's the treatment of the varicocele? The varicocele in most cases is asymptomatic, so the treatment is conservative management. Avoid of the predisposing factors like prolonged standing, straining, and sexual excitement. Frequent cold baths and scrotal suspender relieve the congestion, pain, and the indications of surgery in the varicocele, infertility cases, and painful varicocele that interferes with the physical activities. We have only two indications to do the operation of the varicocele: the infertility and the painful varicocele. We have multiple approaches, like the scrotal approach and inguinal approach, abdominal approach, high approach, prone operation, and the laparoscopic approach. Scrotal approach, now it's done subinguinal approach. Subinguinal at the level of the neck of the scrotum, base of the penis. We open the skin, the muscle, external spermatic fascia, gramastric muscle fascia, internal spermatic fascia, and then we reach the coverings of the spermatic cord. We deliver the spermatic cord, open it, and deliver the veins, ligate the veins, and division. This is a subinguinal approach. The inguinal approach, like the subinguinal approach, but we open the inguinal canal, ligate the veins inside the inguinal canal, but this needs two inguinal hair. Abdominal or high approach, we know that the veins are retroperitoneal, draining on the left renal, in the IVC, so we open the abdomen, like in the case of the appendectomy, but we doesn't open the peritoneum. We reach the retroperitoneum by sweeping the peritoneum medially, then we reach the veins, division and ligation of the veins. And this approach is done by laparoscopy, as we see in this picture. We see the spermatic cord by laparoscopy, and then we deliver the veins, as in the second picture, deliver the veins, division and ligation using clips and cautery to divide the veins. This approach is a very good approach, laparoscopic approach, with maybe two parts only. We can deliver the spermatic cord and deliver the veins through the spermatic cord and clipping and division of the veins. But we have scrotal approach or subinguinal approach, inguinal approach, high approach, balloons operation, and laparoscopic approach. We see in this picture the investigations of the varicocele. This is a duplex ultrasound. The blue color indicates a high flow, high venous flow inside the dilated veins, which is black in color. The dilated veins with high flow. This is indication of the varicocele. Then the semen analysis. The semen analysis concentrate mainly on the sperm count, sperm morphology, and the sperm motility, which all are affected in the varicocele due to impairment of the spermatogenesis. This is normal count in the blue color, and this is in the light brown color. This is the abnormal count of the sperms, the normal morphology, the abnormal morphology, the sperm motility, normal motility, and this is abnormal motility in the cases of the varicocele. We have two investigations mainly, duplex ultrasound and the sperm count. Lastly, what's the meaning of the varicocele? What's the meaning of the varicocele dilatation and elongation and tortuosity of the bambini form plexus? Mainly we have a clinical case in the last year exam. The diagnosis of the case is usually left side primary varicocele, which is not complicated. The examiner will ask you what diagnosis of your case. The diagnosis left side primary varicocele, not complicated. He will ask you how you reach this diagnosis. Left side varicocele, because during an inspection and the complaint of the patient in the left side. He will ask you why it's common in the left side. The varicocele is common on the left side due to four causes. Because the left testis descended before the right testis, so that left testicular veins elongated more than on the right side. The second is the right angle of the left testicular vein, which drain into the left renal vein by a right angle. The left sigmoid, which is loaded with feces, compress the left testicular veins. And the left renal vein have a nutcrack effect due to the superior mesenteric and the aorta. So, well, how you know that it's varicocele? You know that it's varicocele from the history and from the clinical examination. From the history, the patient complaining of bowel aching pain, mentioned long standing with gradual onset. This varicocele and a patient feel it as a bag of worm. When I examine the patient, he have a cystic swelling, which is inguinoscrotal swelling. What's the meaning of inguinoscrotal swelling? Swelling lays at the neck of the scrotum and lay between my index finger and the thumb. How do you know it's a primary, not a secondary varicocele? Due to the age of the patient. The patient is young age. The onset is gradual onset, and the course is progressive course on the sudden onset and acute course. And when I elevate the scrotum, the varicocele disappears. So it's a primary varicocele. Not complicated. What are the complications of the varicocele? Infertility and thrombophlebitis. Fertility, why fertility occur due to increasing temperature and due to reflux of the catecholamines. Lastly, thrombophlebitis, inflammation of the veins. Lastly, what are the investigations which can be done to the case of the varicocele? Doppler ultrasound and sperm count, semen analysis. What is the treatment of the varicocele? Conservative management in most cases. Surgical indication is infertility and severe pain, which is interfering with the physical activities. What are the approaches? Scrotal approach or subinguinal approach, inguinal approach, high approach balloon operation, and this high approach can be done by laparoscopy. This is the varicocele. The second important case in the clinical exam in the last year is the hydrocele. Hydrocele not common than varicocele, but came in the last year exam, clinical exam. What's the meaning of the hydrocele? Hydrocele is a collection of the clear fluid in the tonica vaginalis or the remnant of the processus vaginalis. Hydro meaning water, seal meaning sac. It's a collection of the fluid in the tonica vaginalis or the remnant of the processus vaginalis. We know that the covering of the scrotum is tonica albuginae, the testis, tonica albuginae, which is the white fibrous capsule around the testis, and then the tonica vaginalis, which have two layers, visceral layer and the parietal layer. The tonica vaginalis is derived from the processus vaginalis, which is a vestige from the peritoneum, part from the peritoneum, which taken by the testis during the descent in the intrauterine life. Bitten to processus vaginalis, leading to a combination of the fluid inside it, leading to hydrocele, which is a communicating hydrocele. And it's called congenital hydrocele. Congenital hydrocele, which is a resistant of the processus vaginalis. It's a congenital hydrocele. It's noted dated sense pairs, noted by the mother, scrotal swelling in her baby. This swelling is trans-eliminating swelling, translucent inguinal scrotal swelling, irreducible, we show no impulse in cough. Translucent swelling. As we see in this picture, we put a torch below this swelling, it's translucent swelling, brilliant translucent swelling. Brilliant because the fluid is clear fluid. So scrotal swelling in a young baby, dated since birth, is a congenital hydrocele. What it's caused? It's caused by beta tuberculosis vaginalis. The swelling is translucent swelling. What are the other translucent swelling in surgery? Meningocele. Meningocele is containing clear fluid, which is the CSF. Meningocele occur at the back of the baby. It's translucent swelling. The cystic hygroma. Cystic hygroma is a translucent swelling, lymphatics malformation at the neck of the baby. It's brilliant translucent swelling. Some cases of congenital hernia. 50% of the cases of the congenital hernia is translucent swelling. Laryngocele is a translucent swelling. So what's the translucent swelling is in surgery? Hydrocele, meningocele, cystic hygroma, laryngocele, and 50% of the cases of the congenital hernia. What's the treatment of the congenital hydrocele? Conservative management. It will disappear spontaneously. Conservative. Congenital hydrocele is treated conservatively. The fluid will disappear and the sac will be obliterated. We have another type of the hydrocele, which is the infantile hydrocele. Infantile hydrocele, it's like the congenital hydrocele. Congenital hydrocele is a communicating, as we see in the first picture, communicating with the peritoneal cavity due to latent processus vaginalis. But infantile hydrocele, as we see in the second picture, this is infantile hydrocele. Is infantile hydrocele obliteration of the upper part of the processus vaginalis, but the caudal part, the lower part, is not obliterated. Accumulation of the fluid inside the infantile hydrocele leading to swelling of the scrotum, which is a translucent, brilliant translucent swelling with no impulse and cough. So it's hydrocele. Infantile hydrocele need treatment, excision, because the fluid will accumulate and increase. Non-communicating hydrocele needing excision. Congenital hydrocele needing conservative management. In some cases, the caudal part and the cranial part of the processus vaginalis is obliterated, but the middle part is not obliterated, leading to formation of a sac at the middle part of the processus vaginalis, which is called encysted hydrocele. This encysted hydrocele is translucent swelling because it's containing clear fluid present at the neck of the scrotum. and it's related to the upper pole of the testis, but can be separated from the upper pole of the testis, the excision of this scrotal swelling through scrotal incision or inguinal excision, because not communicating with the peritoneal cavity and will not be drained. Hydrocele of the hernial sac. Hydrocele of the hernial sac, obliteration of the processus vaginalis, caudal part, middle part, but cranial part, which is communicating with the peritoneal cavity. So leading to formation of inguinal swelling or inguinoscrotal swelling, which usually may be associated with hernia, hernial sac, associated with hernia. So complete excision of this sac and this hernial sac. Lastly, hydrocele of canal of neck stimulates the incested hydrocele, but in females. Canal of neck, which stimulating the inguinal canal in males, may be hydrocele on the canal of neck. The treatment of the hydrocele of canal of neck is excision. Lastly, the vaginal hydrocele. The vaginal hydrocele, is the hydrocele of the tonica vaginalis, not communicating hydrocele, not communicating, like in the middle picture, not communicating with the peritoneal cavity. It may be primary or secondary. It occurs in middle age population or in the old population if there is a secondary. As we said, in the varicocele, the primary hydrocele have no obvious cause, which is commoner, but there is some predisposing factors like increased secretion of fluids in the tonica vaginalis, repeated minor traumas, subclinical infections. Secondary hydrocele is common in the cases of trauma, infection, acute epididymal orchitis, tumors of the testis, testicular tumors, varicocele, TB or syphilis, or postoperative due to cutting of the lymphatic drainage of the testis in the hernia operations. So secondary hydrocele is due to trauma, infection, tumors, varicocele, and postoperative. Primary varicocele is most common than secondary varicocele. The pathology of the fluid, which is a straw-colored fluid, straw, yellow color, with specific gravity 1020 to 1024, which contains 6% albumin, suggested for exudate, and cholesterol contents is markedly raised in long-standing cases. In long-standing cases, we have cholesterol contents. How to differentiate between primary varicocele and the secondary varicocele, primary hydrocele and secondary hydrocele? In the primary hydrocele, there is no obvious cause. In secondary hydrocele, there is an evident cause, like history of trauma, mass in the testis, tumor, varicocele, infection, previous operation. Primary hydrocele is usually large and dense, while secondary hydrocele is usually small and lax. What are the complications of the hydrocele? Spontaneous rupture, infection, so it's become iocele, calcification, and atrophy of the testis in long-standing cases. In large cases, interfere with the daily activities, especially sexual activities, leading to mechanical impotence, hernia of the hydrocele sac in communicating the cases. What's the clinical picture of the hydrocele? It's painless, swelling, slowly growing. It's purely scrotal swelling, not inguinoscrotal swelling. Varicocele is inguinoscrotal swelling, while hydrocele is purely, vaginal hydrocele is purely scrotal swelling. The primary hydrocele is pure scrotal swelling, large in color, large in size, smooth, skin over is free, brilliant translucent. This is a characteristic of the vaginal hydrocele. Secondary varicocele, as we said, small and lax. The swelling is detected by obliteration of the sulcus between the testis and the epididymis. Pinching test between parietal layer of the tonica can be pinched from the visceral layer. The investigation of choice for the hydrocele is ultrasound. Differential diagnosis from the other causes of the scrotal swelling. Treatment is the surgical excision of the tonica and the eversion of the tonica. And maybe Lord's operation. Lord's operation is scrotal swelling and all layers of the scrotum is open. The testis is allowed to prolapse through the incision. The tonica is averted on the other layers of the scrotum. Then the tonica is blockaded in a series of radially arranged continuous sutures. Eversion of the tonica. Some doctors may aspirate the fluid, but the aspiration of the fluid leading to infection, leading to biocele, hemorrhage, hematocele, puncture of the testis, or recurrence. How to differentiate between the hydrocele due to malignancy and other causes of the hydrocele? The hydrocele of the malignancy is red in color with residual mass inside the testis, rapid recurrence, and there is a malignant cells in the cytological examination. Again, lastly, hydrocele is a combination of the fluid in the tonica vaginalis, maybe communicating hydrocele or non-communicating hydrocele. Communicating hydrocele is common in newborn babies. It's called congenital hydrocele. While in adult population, the common is a vaginal hydrocele, which is non-communicating, a combination of the fluid between the two layers of the tonica vaginalis, maybe communicating or non-communicating. Communicating in the congenital hydrocele is caused by Betentobrocessus vaginalis, accumulation of the fluid, and this fluid may be absorbed through the peritoneal cavity, so the treatment of congenital hydrocele is conservative management. Vaginal hydrocele may be primary or secondary. We have no obvious cause for the primary hydrocele, but in the secondary hydrocele we have many causes like trauma, tumor, infection, postoperative, and varicocele. How to differentiate between hydrocele of tumor and the other causes? The hydrocele of the tumors have red color, not straw color, red color fluid, and there is a residual mass with rapid accumulation, and the cytological examination of the fluid show malignant cells. How to differentiate between primary and secondary varicocele? Primary varicocele is large and dense, while secondary varicocele is lax and small. Pinch test, we can pinch the testis and we can put our fingers between the tonica parietal layer and the visceral layers of the tonica vaginalis due to laxity of the hydrocele. What's the diagnosis of the hydrocele? Pure scrotal swelling, which is brilliant translucent. What are the other translucent swellings? Other translucent swings, the meningocele, laryngocele, cystic hygroma, 50% of cases of congenital hernia. What's the treatment? Inversion of the tonica and its application. Operation is called Lord's operation. This is hydrocele. The last topic in the tests and the scrotum chapter is the testicular tumors, which is an important topic because early diagnosis may save the patient life. At first, we can take a closer look at the testis histology. The seminiferous tubules, as we said in the last lecture, seminiferous tubules lays between the septa inside the testis, and seminiferous tubules drain into the reti testis. Reti testis forms a vasa efferentia. Vasa efferentia collected with each other to form the epididymis, which is formed from head, body, and tail, and the tail of the epididymis contains as a vast difference which drain into the prostate and the urethra to drain the sperms inside the urethra. But we have a closer look to histological look. If we take a cross-section on the seminiferous tubules, as we see in this picture, we have the germinal epithelium, the germ cells, and then the Sertoli cells, and then the Leydig cells and the spermatozoa. We have two types of tumor. In the tests, germ cell tumor and non-germ cell tumors. We have germinal epithelium and non-germ cells. The germinal epithelium give these tumors germ cell tumors, which is a seminoma, embryonola, teratoma, choriocarcinoma, and the yolk tumor. The non-germ cell tumors, Leydig cell tumor, and Sertoli cell tumors and lymphoma. Mainly, we have seminoma, teratoma, choriocarcinoma, and non-germ cell tumors or interstitial cell tumors, like Leydig cell tumor and Sertoli cell tumor, lastly the lymphoma. The germ cell tumor is the most common, seminoma. Seminoma is the most common testicular tumor. What's the main predisposing factor of the testicular neoplasms in general, we take it in the, last lecture, the undescended testis. The undescended testis is the most common tumor, which is the most common predisposing factor of the testicular tumors. Germ cell tumor like seminoma is the most common testicular tumor. It occurs in young men at the age from 15 to 35 years. The histology is clear cytoplasm and large cell nests of large cells with clear cytoplasm. It's like the fried egg appearance with central nuclei. As you see in the picture, fried egg appearance is the histological appearance of the seminoma. The mass in the cut section is homogeneous. Mass, non-capsulated, pinkish creamy in color. Homogeneous, pinkish creamy in color, which is non-capsulated. The microscopic picture is fried egg appearance with intense lymphocytic infiltration in the tumor. We reflect the good response of the immune system. What's the tumor marker of the seminoma is placental ALP and beta HCG, but not most reliable markers. Presentation, painless unilateral mass. Spread of the seminoma is mostly by lymphatics, rarely by the blood, highly radiosensitive tumor. Again, seminoma is derived from the seminiferous tubules, from the germ cells. It's the most common testicular tumor. The histology is fried egg appearance with intense lymphocytic infiltration, which reflects a good immune response. Seminoma, homogeneous in the cut section, pinkish creamy homogeneous, non-capsulated, spread of the seminoma mainly to the lymphatics. Special character is mainly radiosensitive. The second common germ cell tumor is the teratoma. Teratoma occur in young men or children, pure form in the children. The teratoma is benign in females. Ovarian teratoma is benign in females, while testicular teratoma is mainly malignant. We have four types of teratoma. Teratoma differentiated, which present 0.5% of cases. The best example is the dermoid cyst. The malignant teratoma intermediate, the teratocarcinoma, and the malignant teratoma anaplastica, which undifferentiated embryonic cells, embryonal carcinoma, and lastly, malignant teratoma trophoblastica, the choriocarcinoma. It's composed of synechial cell mass with malignant pellous papillary cytotrophoblasts, the most malignant tumor known. The cytoplasm containing beta HCG. The tumor marker of the teratoma is the beta HCG, chronic gonadotrophin hormone. Tumor marker is the beta HCG. So the patient with teratoma have a positive pregnancy test. The appearance, the mass may contain hair, muscles, and the neural tissues. Malignant in adult males, unlike in the adult females. Choriocarcinoma, so case in young men. Histology, synechial cell masses with malignant cytotrophoblasts. Tumor marker beta HCG, testicular mass with gynecomastia, and the hypertrophied mets of the lung. As we see in this picture, choriocarcinoma has a metastasis to the lung. The non-germ cell tumors, the leading cell tumor, androgen and estrogen producing leading cell tumor. Leading to precocious puberty and infantile Hercules appearance. The tumor is golden brown in color. Tumor marker is not known. Lastly, the post-pubertal tumor, which is a Sertoli cell tumor. It occurs after the puberty, secrete estrogen, causes gynecomastia and loss of libido. Lymphoma of the testis, it's occur in elderly population. It's usually bilateral and invades the blood vessels. What's the spread of the testicular tumors? The seminoma spread by lymphatic spread. We say it in the anatomy, the lymphatic drainage of the testis mainly to the para-aortic lymph nodes, from the para-aortic lymph nodes to the cisterna chyli, from the cisterna chyli to the thoracic duct, from the thoracic duct to the vercal lymph nodes. If there is invasion of the epididymis, the spread mainly to the internal iliac lymph nodes. If there is invasion of the scrotal skin, the inguinal lymph nodes are enlarged. blood spread occur in the teratoma, as we see in the X-ray picture reaching the lung. Let's do cannonball metastasis. What's the clinical picture of the clinical picture of the testicular tumor? Painless, slowly, rapidly growing scrotal swelling. Solid swelling, not cystic swelling. Pain, which is dragging pain. Symptoms of metastasis like the hemoptysis and the pathological fractures. Again, painless, rapidly growing swelling of the testis is a testicular tumor. Painless, rapidly growing scrotal swelling is a testicular tumor. Pain may occur in 30% of the cases, and this pain is dragging pain due to hemorrhage inside the tumor. And symptoms of metastasis. By examination, the testis is enlarged from the other side, with consistency of a solid mass. Epididymis is early normal, but later may be infiltrated. Secondary hydrocele may present in 10% of the cases. What's the investigations? Tumor markers, beta HCG is elevated in the cases of teratoma. Alpha fetoprotein elevated in non-seminomatous tumors. Alpha fetoprotein may be enlarged, may be positive, and likely lactate dehydrogenase isoenzyme I is increased in the some cases, and it's helpful in the follow-up and during and after treatment of the testicular tumors. The imaging is scrotal ultrasound. Biopsy, needle biopsy is contraindicated because leads to spread. Open biopsy, incisional or excisional biopsy through inguinal incision. The other investigations is abdominal CT scan to detect the paraaortic lymph nodes, and bone scan to detect the spread, CT chest to detect the cannonball metastasis, and eye view to detect the enlarged lymph nodes at the course of the ureter compressing the renal vessels. But CT scan replacing the eye view. The CT abdomen, CT chest, bone scan. CT abdomen, CT chest, and bone scan. The differential diagnosis is from other intrascrotal swelling, especially sephiratic orchitis. But in the sephiratic orchitis, the weight of the testis is lightweight, and loss of the testicular sensation. While in the malignancy, there is no loss of the testicular sensation, and the testis is heavy in weight. What's the treatment? The treatment is orchidectomy high through an inguinal incision, high retrograde orchidectomy, and block dissection of the paraaortic lymph nodes. Or maybe orchidectomy and postoperative radiotherapy to avoid the block dissection of the paraaortic lymph nodes, especially in the cases of seminoma, because the seminoma is highly radiosensitive tumor. Teratoma is less radiosensitive, so we can only follow up by markers in the stage 1, stage 2, 3. We have a combination of chemotherapy like cisplatin, methotrexate, sulfentrazine, and other to prefer. Add bleomycin combination chemotherapy with the orchidectomy and block dissection of the paraaortic lymph nodes. The 5-year survival rate in seminoma is better than teratoma. 5-year survival rate is better in seminoma, better than teratoma. Lastly, the testicular neoplasms may be germ cell tumors or non-germ cell tumors. The common testicular neoplasm is the seminoma. And the second is teratoma. The interstitial cell tumors or non-germ cell tumors is the leading cell tumors, hepatocellular cell tumor, and a lymphoma. A seminoma is from the seminiferous tubules. It's adenocarcinoma of the seminiferous tubules. The microscopic picture is the fried egg with intense lymphocytic infiltration. Seminoma spread mainly to the lymphatics, rarely to the blood, highly radiosensitive. Teratoma may be differentiated teratoma, undifferentiated teratoma, embryonal carcinoma, and choriocarcinoma, which has a tendency to metastasis to the lung due to cannonball metastasis with positive pregnancy test due to secretion of beta HCG. Interstitial cell tumors, leading cell tumor, secretes testosterone, so occurs before puberty leading to infantile Hercules. While post-pubertal tumor, like Sertoli cell tumor, secretes estrogen leading to loss of libido and gynecomastia. Lymphoma occurs in old age, usually bilateral. Spread of the testicular tumors, mainly to the paraaortic lymph nodes. If the epididymis is infiltrated, it's to the internal iliac lymph nodes. If the scrotal skin is infiltrated, it's to the inguinal lymph nodes. What's the blood spread cannonball metastasis and the choriocarcinoma? What's the presentation of the testicular tumor? Painless, rapidly progressive, increasing in size, scrotal swelling. mainly differentiation is the syphilitic orchitis. But in syphilis, there is loss of testicular sensation, and the testis is lighter than the normal weight. While in the testicular tumor, it's heavier than due to reasons of MS. There is maybe symptoms of the spread, like hemoptysis, enlargement of the para-aortic lymph nodes, enlargement of the Virchow lymph node. Tumor marker, human colonic gonadotropin beta subunit. In non-seminomatous tumors, it's present in 65%. Alpha fetoprotein increase also in non-seminomatous tumors. In lactate dehydrogenase isoenzyme I increase in some cases and used for follow-up pre- and post-treatment. Biopsy, neither biopsy is contraindicated. The incisional or excisional biopsy through high ligation. Investigation to detect the LMS, scrotal ultrasound, CT abdomen, CT chest, bone scan. Treatment is retrograde high orchidectomy through inguinal incision with block dissection of the para-aortic lymph nodes. Orchidectomy, the postoperative radiotherapy is the treatment of choice in seminoma, while in teratoma, the chemotherapy is added in the stage 2 and stage 3 and stage 4. Seminoma is better in prognosis than teratoma. Thank you.